guess. My dog.
Hi, guys. It is a cold, gloomy midwinter night here on the first weekend of summer 2021. Yes, I guess we're supposed to be kicking off summer here on Saturday, May 29th, 2021, where it is about 43 degrees right now at Bugs in a Jar Farm outside of Ithaca, New York. Happy summer 2021. So, since I have no life because I became a doomer 12 years ago and I interrupted my life and have nothing else to do on Saturday night, Memorial Day weekend, I just remembered that we had a collapse of global industrial civilization on my camera right in the middle of my Manga Bay Ecological Meltdown Roundup rant. So we're gonna give global industrial civilization one more chance. If my camera turns off during this rant, I guess the universe does not want you to hear all of the doomer news from mongabay.com. So we're gonna pick up where I think we left off. Yeah, we were just starting when the camera shut off talking about sustainability in the rubber industry, asking the question, what stops the rubber industry from being sustainable? Well, it's the same thing that stops everything, every other industry from being sustainable on the planet. It makes no difference what it is. There are too many people on the planet buying this crap. There is no industry that is sustainable. The very notion of this whole notion of sustainability on a planet of 8 billion people is patently absurd. The very notion of it is patently absurd. It is an unsustainable planet. There are too many consumers to sustain consumption. I don't give a damn what it is. And so this is just this usual greenwashing gobbledygook about some sort of certified rubber, that the rubber on your tires or something is some sort of save the planet rubber, all this crap. Don't buy this for 1 minute, people. I'm embarrassed for Rhett Butler at Manga Bay for running this crap. Rhett Butler knows as well as I and Sancho Panza that there is nothing sustainable about the rubber industry, and because there's too damn many people buying tires. And one of the reason, well, it's not just, and not only are there too many people buying tires, but there's a lot more tires being sold to tire consumers because of an issue that is never mentioned anywhere in the article, and this is planned obsolescence that these tire companies, 70% of rubber goes into tires. And the tires on your electric vehicle use the same tires as any other gas-sucking car, okay? And that these tires could last the life of a car, that they build into the tire that it wears out a lot sooner than it needs to, number one, and then they convince you that you need to buy tires, new tires, a lot sooner than you do. These are the reasons that the rubber industry, like every other industry, is sustainable. It's these greedy bastards pulling all of these tricks to make this crap break down. It's these PR guys convincing you that you need to buy this crap that you don't need in your life. And most importantly, there's too damn many people on the planet buying this crap. This is why the very notion of a sustainable industry, be it rubber, palm oil, lumber, whatever, is patently absurd. Okay, this whole notion, sustainable development, sustainable industry, it's greenwashing crap. And again, as I say, I do not know why Rhett Butler is a mouthpiece for the global corporatocracy selling us these greenwashing lies. It's a big, fat lie. Anyway, okay. Now, I'm not even going to get into this one, this part of the debate. Human rights must be at the heart of a new biodiversity framework. So I love this. They're working, the United Nations is working on a new agreement to save the planet's biodiversity, which will replace the previous 10-year Aichi agreements, which have been considered a failure as a grand total of zero of the 20 biodiversity targets were met. It was an abject failure, 20 out of 20 targets to save the rest of our earthlings from humans failed. So the way we're going to save the rest of the rights of every earthling we share this planet with is to put human rights at the centerpiece. And don't even get me going. This dredges up all of the noble savage fantasy, all of this big, this big debate about kicking off indigenous people off of their lands to set aside lands as a national park or whatever. I don't have time to get into all of this. I don't work for the United Nations. I do not think human rights should be the centerpiece of a biodiversity target to save our rights of our fellow earthlings for life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, to give humans, put them in the middle of it. Yes, this is like putting Sancho Panza in the middle of a chipmunk rights. What do you think? Would you like to have Sancho Panza rights as the centerpiece of a chipmunk, save the chipmunks target, Sancho Panza? Anyway, I don't even want to dig into what this story is talking about. In Madagascar, cultural taboos can protect or harm the environment. I'm sure there's many examples of how a Madagascar cultural taboo can save the fellow earthlings in Madagascar. Now this is, I don't really know it. It's, the title of this is U.S. Journalist Arrested When Trying to Leave, do you pronounce it Myanmar? I've never known how to pronounce this country. It's Burma. I pronounce Myanmar, Burma. Danny Fenster, an American journalist working in Burma, was detained today by local authorities. I'm guessing, I don't know why this is showing up in Manga Bay. I guess he was covering environmental issues or otherwise. I don't know why. why they would be talking about this in Mangum. I'm assuming he was trying to expose some sort of corrupt planet eater, I'm taking a wild guess that he was blowing some kind of whistle on some kind of planet eating. It appears that Fenster has been taken to, I love the name of this, Insane Prison. Yes. Insane Prison. Okay, here we go. Again, get your salt shaker of grains of salt here. Belize's Maya Forest Corridor is a missing link to giant rainforest reserve. Yes, with nearly 40% of its lands under no protected area status, Belize already contributes significantly to the IUCN's post-2020 biodiversity framework of preserving 30% of the planet by 2030. And so now what they're talking about, you know, these forest corridors, which are a great idea, you know, connecting these different protected areas, these little corridors, usually along rivers, to connect these big protected areas. So see, this is what I love, is it would also, talking about how it would connect to adjacent protected areas of La Selva Maya in Guatemala and Mexico to become the largest rainforest preserve north of the Amazon. Of course, the problem, I have been to the La Selva Maya Reserve in Guatemala. It is a joke. I'm just real quickly. So if I were Rhett Butler and I had received this, I would have put La Selva Maya Forest Preserve land grabbing. Let's Google something like that. Anyway, guys, you can do this yourself. All of these places, they're a joke, okay? These protected areas, they're better than nothing at all. But what these corridors are doing is protecting one deforested, mined, whatever area. But as I say, I guess good news, the definition of good news in 2021, okay. Now we're going to have a little, we are going to have a C word story. So anybody believing that the Corona panic is only good for this planet, I want you to fast forward for a couple of minutes. Wow, where have we heard this story 500 times in the last year and a half? Where is Sulawesi? That's in Indonesia. Illegal loggers use Corona panic as a cover to ramp up logging activity in Sulawesi. Illegal logging on Indonesia's Sulawesi Island has intensified by more than two-thirds during the Corona panic, according to a local NGO. It attributes this increase to monitoring by law enforcers having to be scaled back as part of wider mobility restrictions imposed in response to the pandemic, otherwise known as these lockdowns. Police have charged a senior local politician with involvement in the illegal logging.
Yes.
All right. What's going on with indigenous people in Colombia? Violence against indigenous and local groups deplored amid Colombia protest. So there, I guess there's all of these various protests going on and against, and of course a bunch of heads getting knocked. Various NGOs have recorded some 2,000 cases of violence against protesters since April 28, with more than 1,000 arbitrary arrests, at least 40 deaths, and dozens of disappearances and attacks. Do you think so? Social and environmental organizations such as Amazon Watch and the Nature Conservancy have expressed concern about human rights violations and violence against indigenous peoples. Yep. All right, so let's look at Madagascar's vanishing trees. Madagascar has a documented 2,900 endemic species of trees, but a new report shows that almost two-thirds of them are now in danger of disappearing. Yes. Of the 3,100 species covered, more than 90% have never been systematically evaluated before, and 1 in 10 species fell in the IUCN's critically endangered category, one step away from going extinct in the wild. Yes, scientists are racing against the extinction clock to document this mind-boggling biodiversity and to determine just how imperiled individual species are. Yes. Okay, we have Norway saving the planet as a Norwegian poultry producer bars Brazilian soy due to deforestation risk. Good for you. You will not believe this one, guys. See, this is why I depend on Manga Bay for such hard-cutting environmental news. I never would have understood this if Rhett Butler wasn't around to explain this to me every week. Did you realize that illegal clearing for agriculture is driving tropical deforestation? Wow. I never would have thought this. In a new report, the NGO Forest Trends found that at least 69% of tropical forests cleared for agricultural activities such as ranching and farmland between 2013 and 2019 was done in violation of national laws and regulations. Yes, the actual amount of illegally, and again, I'm not going to get into my weekly rant about illegal versus legal deforestation. They're just talking about the illegally deforested land is immense during that period. 31.7 million hectares, known about 75 million acres, an area roughly the size of Norway. The study notes that if tropical deforestation emissions tied to agriculture were a country, it would rank third behind China and the U.S. Yes. Vietnam is planting 1 billion trees to save the planet by 2025. Yes. Past reforestation campaigns have succeeded in increasing Vietnam's overall tree cover, but mainly by establishing plantations of non-native species that are then regularly clear-cut again for paper or timber. Some organizations and farmers are working to change the way Vietnam approaches reforestation, you know, which is planting a bunch of non-native tree farms and then clear-cutting them. Yes, I love the term reforestation. It's called planting a cornfield. There you go. Well, anyway, guys, I guess I'm, since I got halfway through yesterday, I guess this is just part two of this roundup, because everything else seems to be, stories from last week. Well, long as we're over here and we have a few minutes left, let's go over to Center for Biological Diversity. I used to cover Center for Biological Diversity in this rant, but somehow I let them loose. So we're going to spend a couple of minutes over at Endangered Earth. Here is, as massive hunts loom, we push to save wolves. After Idaho and Montana pass laws that could brutally massacre their wolf populations, the Center for Biological Diversity and Allies petitioned this week to restore federal protection to those states' wolves. This is the center's Andrea Zaccardi. Quote, Idaho's and Montana's legislative directives to kill wolves by nearly any means possible seriously endanger wolf populations in the West. That is the reason for the laws, to make wolves extinct again. Anyway, the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service should immediately return Endangered Species Act protection to these wolves to halt the impending statewide slaughter before it's too late. I'm going to try to be optimistic here and say Joe Biden is going to come in and save the wolves that Donald Trump, you know, sold down the river. It was Donald Trump's U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service that stripped protection from wolves setting up the slaughter. You know, when the Trump administration stripped federal protection, that gave states, you know, they are the ones who now control wolf management, which is another way of saying wolf slaughter. I cannot believe they're still talking about the prairie chicken proposed. I guess this is the lesser prairie chicken proposed for protection. Good Lord, good for the lesser prairie chicken. We're still talking about Donald Trump over here. Trump EPA quashed science to okay dangerous pesticide. Do you think so? A scathing new federal report shows that powerful pesticide officials in Trump's Environmental Protection Agency purposely omitted evidence of the dangers of the pesticide dicamba before approving its use in 2018. The Office of the Inspector General found that senior Trump staffers changed and left out research-based evidence of dicamba's risks, which has damaged millions of acres of crops and now threatens monarch butterflies. And so hopefully, good old Joe Biden will save the monarchs. We will see. Okay. So, here is, they're trying to get more of these wildlife crossings in California. These things actually work pretty good for keeping animals from getting run over. Car strikes are killing California's mountain lions, kit foxes, and tortoises while highways block their ability to find food, mates, and shelter. This investment would save countless animals' lives and families. Promo for the condor and the eagle. I hear that's a pretty good show. So I guess if you go on to Center for Biological Diversity on June 3rd and 4th, you can watch the dog. That would be what, next Saturday and Sunday night, 7 p.m. Eastern Time. I think is what they're saying. Anyway, go on Center for Biological Diversity and get the link to the condor and the eagle. Okay, the U.S. must join the Convention on Biological Diversity. Yep. It's crucial that the United States, as a world leader, join the International Convention on Biological Diversity. We are the only nation that has not ratified this vital convention, and that needs to change. Yes, we need to get the U.S. on board with this latest. What did we just say in the Manga Bay rant? Exactly 0 out of 20 biodiversity targets. But we're going to put human rights in the middle of the new targets. That'll save the planet. Anyway, guys, I got to get the heater turned back on this exciting Saturday night here on Memorial Day weekend. And I was going to have an announcement tonight about the interviews on Collapse Chronicles, but apparently that announcement has been put on hold. Anyway, we'll see if we're coming back with more on that in the near future. Party down on the first weekend of summer while I go put on my new flannel sheets I just bought at a garage sale. Bye, guys. Yes, little dog. You say, Pop, what are you doing ranting on a Saturday night? I'm ranting on a Saturday night because we don't have a life. We are doomers. We are doomers. We do not have lives. So we sit around and talk to ourselves on Saturday night, Memorial Day weekend, because we don't have a date. Bye, guys.